The way we do it is called the way of Raja Yoga. It is based on Hatha Yoga Kriyas or Tantric Yoga, but the method is Raja Yoga. Raja Yoga would mean the royal pathway. That means not much is to be done, everything is done by itself. What we do is we only clear the pathway. The Kundalini, when it arises, it will arise by itself. We just clean the road, the pathway, we clean it, we clean and clean and clean. When the road is clear, then the Royal Highness will start to move. I think that is okay. The Royal Highness will start to move. That's how the Rajas are, the kings are. Only when there is no traffic jam and there are enough outriders, start to move. So similarly, in ancient times, they have to sweep the road, clear the pathway, get all the people out of the way, and then the king or the queen will start to move in her chariot. Understand that? It's the same way for the Kundalini. So, this is how we do it. We will keep on rotating the awareness until sometime you feel the energy movement. With the energy movement, it is not so much, don't anticipate some form of very physical feelings. Don't anticipate that. There will be changes and people around you will see the changes in the form of temperament changing, becoming more aware, much more calmer, much more intelligent, much more aware and attuned with the surrounding, but very much in the center, means you are not disturbed. Understand that? But still dynamic, still able to interact with society. This balance is very important. Very few people, because they think there is so much of rules and regulations. Cannot eat before asana, cannot sleep, cannot do this, cannot be married, so many things, right? But is it all true? Or is it just a kind of a fencing in the beginning? When you are planting a seed, when you have planted a seed, the seed is growing, it's sprouting. In the beginning you need some kind of protection, correct? A little bit of fencing. When it has grown into a big tree, do you need the fencing? No, it will provide the support and protection for other animals also. People can come and sit under the tree. So like this, this propagation of the rules and regulations are in the beginning. That you need to adhere to this. Without discipline, can we achieve anything? You can't achieve anything. You can't even climb the Everest. Don't talk about base camp. Right? So, even the most simplest thing that we want to achieve some form of success, there needs to be discipline. But here, discipline in Kriya Yoga is the discipline that is needed to come Satres 3:30, that's all. Good news, huh? You don't have to even practice how powerful it is. The technique is so powerful that you don't even need to do it. I see a lot of people smiling. That you don't even need to do it at home. Just come once a week is good enough. Let me draw a parallel with the trainings that you may have had. Now, in school, some of you took part in athletics, right? And your training is maybe like once a week, twice a week. So let's say you were training for hockey. Once a week you are asked to go for a hockey game. So you play hockey, and after about 6 months, did you improve? Were you able to play well? Once a week, you were playing once a week, you were able to improve and come to the level, correct? Same thing you look at martial arts. When somebody, let's say your brother, or when you were training in martial arts, taekwondo or karate or jiu-jitsu, whatever. You went once a week, once a week, once a week, every 3 months you have the grading. And during the grading, your improvement is there. You can see it 3 months ago and now. And then 6 months later, 9 months later, 3 years later. But you go once a week. By the time you reach a good belt, like a black belt or some other belt, you will be like that level, correct? It's once a week. You understand what I'm saying? Now, sadhana or practice is the same way. As long as we are able to do it consistently, but not fanatically. It should not be such that you force yourself. Don't use this word, I should practice. Why? Why this word should not be used? Should not be used. Because it creates a form of forcing. When you tell your children, you should do your homework, what will they feel? You should not watch TV. So your brain is saying the same thing. Get alcohol. So here, only thing I'm asking you, you should come for class at 3 o'clock. Understand what I'm saying? Don't use the word should. Just that if you feel you want to practice, practice. But not once a year. No, just that feeling of wanting to do it from, not from the neocortex, but feel, just enjoy. Start with a small block of time, let's say 1.5 minutes. 15 minutes is a good time. Do like 15 minutes. And then these 15 minutes, you can do just before breakfast. And other times that you can do is, all these practices, you can do any other time. While taking a break from your office, or while